This is Sergeant Chris Richardson with the Tennessee Highway Patrol. Pedestrian safety is a two-way street. Both drivers and walkers need to do their part to keep roads safe. When you're walking, remember, the drivers may not always see you, so you need to walk safe. Wear bright clothes, always use crosswalks, and obey signs. Lights and reflectors should be used. And finally, keep alert and do not walk distracted. This message brought to you by the Tennessee Highway Patrol.
CJ Used Appliances, located at 3530 Jackson Avenue here in Memphis, Tennessee. Call them at 901-487-7882. CJ Used Appliances has the best prices in town, sales and service, heating and air, also the best appliances you'll find anywhere in the Mid-South. Refrigerators, microwave stoves, washers and dryers, deep freezers, dishwashers, whatever you need in used appliances. And folks, I'm telling you, they're the best used appliances anywhere you'll find. That's CJ Used Appliances, 3530 Jackson Avenue. All appliances come with warranty. You can call them at 901-487-7882. Again, 901-487-7882. CJ Used Appliances. The Graphic Printing, located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis, a complete print shop for all your printing needs. They do it all. Color copy, resumes, funeral programs, rubber stamps, full-color business cards, wedding and graduation invitations, and more. 30-plus years of quality work and service. They're open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m., located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis, Tennessee, 901-345-9294. Graphics Printing. C&S Motors Auto Sales, located at 2508 Summer Avenue here in Memphis, Tennessee. Call them at 901-323-8778. C&S Motors Auto Sales has been around since 1984. Go by and see Chris today for some of the best pre-owned and used vehicles in the city. They have SUVs, minivans, cars, trucks, whatever you're looking for in pre-owned used vehicles. Hey, you can find it right there at C&S Motors Auto Sales. See Chris since 1984. They will treat you right. Call them at 901-323-8778. That's 901-323-8778. 2508 Summer Avenue, C&S Motors Auto Sales.
This is Sergeant Chris Richardson with the Tennessee Highway Patrol, here to explain the Tennessee Hands-Free Law, which is a new state law effective July 1st, 2019. In Public Chapter 412, it makes it illegal for a driver to hold a cell phone or a mobile device with any part of their body, to write, send, or read any text-based communication, to reach for a cell phone or mobile device in a manner that requires the driver to no longer be in a seated driving position or properly restrained by a seatbelt, to watch a video or a movie on a cell phone or a mobile device, and to record or broadcast video on a cell phone or mobile device. So, can I still talk on my cell phone while driving? Yes. A driver is permitted to use an earpiece, headphone device, or a device worn on a wrist to conduct a voice-based communication. A driver may use one button on a cell phone or mobile device to initiate or terminate voice communication, and voice-based communication may also be used to send a text message. Learn more at handsfreetn.com.
Max Back Taxes, 4422 Yale Road here in Memphis, Tennessee, 901-382-1414. Get the maximum back on your taxes. It is now tax season. 15 years in business, precise, professional, and honest. Hey, you need to go by Max Back Taxes, 4422 Yale Road. Call 901-382-1414 and talk to Tamara. Get the maximum back on your taxes with Max Back Taxes. CJ Used Appliances, located at 3530 Jackson Avenue here in Memphis, Tennessee. Call them at 901-487-7882. CJ Used Appliances has the best prices in town, sales and service, heating and air, also the best appliances you'll find anywhere in the Mid-South. Refrigerators, microwave stoves, washers and dryers, deep freezers, dishwashers, whatever you need in used appliances. And folks, I'm telling you, they're the best used appliances anywhere you'll find. That's CJ Used Appliances, 3530 Jackson Avenue. All appliances come with warranty. You can call them at 901-487-7882. Again, 901-487-7882. CJ Used Appliances. Max Back Taxes, 4422 Yale Road here in Memphis, Tennessee, 901-382-1414. Get the maximum back on your taxes. It is now tax season. 15 years in business, precise, professional, and honest. Hey, you need to go by Max Back Taxes, 4422 Yale Road. Call 901-382-1414 and talk to Tamara. Get the maximum back on your taxes with Max Back Taxes.
Good morning again, and welcome to Talk Back Live in the morning. It is now, I'll pull it down here, 8:11, the hour of 8 o'clock Central Time, and a very pleasant good morning to you on a Tuesday morning. Yes, a lovely, wonderful Tuesday morning, and starting your day off at 25 degrees. Yes, 25 degrees under a cloudy sky. A beautiful day to start your day on a Tuesday, regardless of how cold it is. Well, I tell you what, folks, we have a great show lined up for you today. Hot topics of discussion, news that you could use, local, national, international. And the number to call is 901-213-6020. Again, the number to call is 901-213-6020, and we'll be glad to talk with you and have you to talk with us concerning our topics for today. Got some great topics coming your way today, and maybe a question of the day as well. Hey, I tell you what, it's going to be a great one, and it's cold. Buckle down, warm up, and stay right there. Good morning, Josh.
Good morning, Bob. Good morning out there listening, watching, tuning in, wherever you may be, however you may be checking us out this morning. Another great show we got lined up for you today. Mm-hmm. As Bob said, man, definitely glad to be back this week, man, to get the week started on this Tuesday. And, man, so much stuff's been going on, so we're going to try to dive into as much stuff as possible on today. And we definitely appreciate all of y'all that are coming on in the room this morning. It is much appreciated. So shout out to y'all. Also, you can follow the show on multiple different platforms.
Yeah.
Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to GKP who's out there, I'm sure, this morning.
Yeah.
But follow us on Facebook, TalkBackLive with Bob and Josh, as you see there. Also on Twitter, at TalkBackLive. That's one word, at TalkBackLive. Also, there are the platforms. You can follow us on the podcast apps. That's including Spotify, Google Podcasts, and iHeartRadio. Now, those are for after the show's over. You can go and listen to the archived versions of all of our episodes we've done. Plus, if you want to listen to us live and in living sound, you can go to the Spotify app. That's Spreaker. Spreaker app.
Yeah.
Spreaker. It's free download on any device you may have. Y'all go check that out, man. And you can follow us on there. Listen live, whatever you're doing. Mm-hmm. If you're working out in the gym, you're jogging, you're at work, you want to put some earbuds in and not have the video feed on your phone, you want to listen in, you can do that as well on Spotify, on Spreaker, my goodness. Spreaker. Y'all go check that out for free. So, those are the platforms you can check us out, man. So, without any further ado, at least for me on this end, we can get it on.
All right, then. I tell you what, it is 25 degrees, cloudy sky. Did you get any snow? Did you get snowed in last night? Well, I tell you what, we'll talk about that and some other things as well. Yeah. Hey, let's get it on. In the headlines today, we've got a lot of things to talk about, really. The cold weather, we've got the Your Highness. Well, you know what I'm talking about. And we've got money being found. We've got Tennessee to talk about. Well, the Super Bowl. Well, let's talk about it. Josh, this morning we'll start out our story, our topic this morning with... what's going on with Your Highness, Harry and Meghan? What's the big deal about these two these days? And why is the situation turning out the way it is? You know, I'm just saying. I'm asking. I'm not saying that, you know. I'm just saying, why is it turning out the way it's turning out? Maybe. Give us an idea. Maybe, I don't know. And maybe the people can tell us, too. What's going on with this story?
Well, it's one of them things. As I turn off this stupid alarm that nobody set, but it keeps going off anyway. And shout out to that. But anyway, So, what we're talking about is the royal family, and I know it's one of those things we haven't really talked about on the show. And to me, one thing I have said, and even when we were on the radio about the whole royal family thing.
Yeah, we're on the radio now. I'm not on radio. Go ahead.
I know. Just stop. And I don't...
Okay, go ahead.
It's just a comment in passing.
I know.
You know, because... Anyway, what we mentioned in the past... To put it that way, is about the royal family. I'm like, hey, I don't care. I never cared about the royal family, and I never understood the whole appeal about following Harry and all those other folks and who they marry and whatever the case is. But this situation has gotten my attention a little bit more. And I think more people that, even some of those folks that felt the way I did about this situation, because you see what looks like is an injustice going on or something weird with the family that has been going on before. Now, y'all know Harry has married a half woman, Meghan Markle, who's also an actor, into the family. And ever since then, it seems like it's been turmoil left and right with the family and something in regards to her or him or them. And now it's gotten to the point where they don't want to be a part of what the royal family is all about anymore. So that's,
I don't know. So, I mean,
well, that's what it is. Like, that's okay, exactly
so,
what's happening.
So because she's half white and half black, and she's got a little black in her, so now people want to start saying that this is the reason why she's not, the situation going the way it is because the half black in her is not being accepted?
I don't know. That's been talked about. Yeah. And that's not even really what I'm saying. But I do think it's an interesting conversation to bring up. You know, you got to wonder what has gotten to the point where a guy that's basically, you grow up in this whole line of royalty and everything else, and now you're ready to take your family away from this, his own family.
Yeah,
he's got kids and everything else. And he says, I don't want to be a part of this anymore. Why? One has to wonder.
Is there a story that we can play on this?
There is. Okay. There's no video, of course, but we do have the audio of the video.
Okay, let's take a listen to this. And when you give us your opinion of what's going on with this whole thing, take a listen. Josh, you ready?
Just a second.
Okay. With the Harry, Meghan situation, and they're talking about Canada back and forth with this whole thing. And some people are saying that it's because the reason all this stuff is going down is because this woman that he's married to now is have some black in her. So the black in her is sending them through this whole situation. If she was a completely white woman or anything else, then there wouldn't be this problem, some people say they don't think. Should we bring race into this? At all? Or is it just that some people are just wanting to just start something here?
What the?
Yeah, 901-213-6020. 901-213-6020. And your comments and questions or whatever you want to do are welcome on this situation. You ready, Josh?
Yeah.
All right, let's get it on. Take a listen to this, folks. Give us your opinion. What do you think? 901-213-6020. Leave it on Facebook, as a lot of you are doing right now. Take a listen to this.
To withdraw from official duties, Prince Harry says he had no other option but to cut most of his royal ties. As you might expect, it is all over Britain's front pages this morning. Harry gave an emotional speech last night after Queen Elizabeth announced the highly anticipated details of the new arrangement for him and his wife, Meghan. It's an extraordinary break for a couple who had hoped to introduce, it seems, a more progressive era for Britain's royals. Charlie Daggett is at Buckingham Palace with more on the story. Charlie, what are they saying in the UK today?
Well, Gail, you know, they said they wanted out and they are out. They're out, out. But the details of this agreement outline a significant split between the couple and the rest of the royal family.
Once Meghan and I were married, we were excited. We were hopeful and we were here to serve. For those reasons, it brings me great sadness that it has come to this.
It has come to this, laid out by the Queen in a courteous but clear divorce statement. Gone is the use of the royal titles, his and her Royal Highness. Gone is the public funding. They'll pay back the $3.1 million in taxpayer money spent renovating their Frogmore Cottage home near Windsor Castle. If the Queen was feeling the strain, she wasn't showing it as she attended church yesterday. In her statement, she said, "Harry, Meghan, and Archie will always be much-loved members of my family." But gone, too, are the military titles and patronages awarded to Prince Harry after serving two terms in Afghanistan. He will no longer attend events in uniform. Harry said that one hurt. But at an event for his HIV charity sent to Bali, he said the couple's work would continue.
"What I want to make clear is we're not walking away. And we certainly aren't walking away from you. Our hope was to continue serving the Queen, the Commonwealth, and my military associations, but without public funding. Unfortunately, that wasn't possible."
What is now possible is the couple can begin building their own brand, and there has been speculation they intend to establish a foundation similar to the Obamas.
"It means that Meghan in particular will be able to support causes of women's empowerment that people in the palace here would think were too political."
Robert Lacey is a royal historian and consultant for the Netflix series The Crown. And now unburdened by the royal family.
"Freedom is a big element in this. You know, that's what you people have always been about. And that's what they sense in North America. And that's what they want to enjoy. And I hope they do, and I'm sure they will."
Well, for the time being anyway, it's business as usual. We just got some information this morning from the palace saying that Harry attended an African investment summit this morning. The point is he'll be doing these official duties and engagements until the agreement kicks in this spring. Tony?
Mr. Lacey's right there. We people.
We like that freedom thing a lot.
Charlie,
it's very complicated.
At the Royal Palace Force. Charlie, thank you very much. Yeah, it is very complicated. One thing that wasn't in the piece is that interesting phrase from Prince Harry, the decision I made for my wife and I.
Yes.
Yeah, but we all know that they certainly made that decision together. I think it was nice that he phrased it that way because she's getting so blasted and hammered in the British press.
Yeah, trying to take the burden out of it.
I took it. I have no inside information about that, but clearly they made that decision together.
Yeah.
All right, there. I see a lot of people coming in on some things here. Oh, boy. So Meghan comes in half white, half black. And the black in her, for some reason, some people say, I'm just out of it, folks. Leave me out of it. Some people are saying that because of the black in Meghan, that this is why they're going through all the stuff. Now, this is a sad situation that Harry, you know, he decides to stay with his wife, irregardless of all the racism. He'd rather leave the royalty behind and stay with his wife, whether she's black, white, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Do you believe that? And also, one of the other sad things is the military service that he served, you know, his title is not as secure as it used to be. Or his title is not there anymore.
Yeah, I mean,
he served that. That's something he did himself.
Yeah, I know.
But they could take that away?
That's what it sounds like. And one thing I'm hearing, too, is... on this part sounds like it's his home doing, what I'm about to talk about. And that's the Your Highness stuff.
Yeah.
He's not wanting to go by that anymore.
Uh-huh.
Now, according to, you know, the queen or whatever, the royal patriarchy, he can still use that if he wants.
Mm-hmm.
And that it's still applicable, but he's choosing to separate himself. Now, here's the thing. When I listen to this story,
mm-hmm.
it sounds like they're kind of trying to frame this as a friendly pull because of differences.
Mm.
But to me, you know, and like I said, it's not like I'm trying to create it to be something. But when you say you have no other choice but to leave from your own family... in this situation, that should never be the case unless something really happened.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, you know, for the queen to say, hey, they have no problem with this, and Harry to say it was all, you know, it's all good. I don't think it's all good as they say it is. Mm-hmm. And, hey, if he decided to take a stand, that's on him.
Yeah.
And they want to live normal lives, it sounds like, and be free. So what exactly are they free of, though? That's all. These are all questions to be answered. What was being so restrictive that seemingly hasn't happened before?
Yeah, that's a good question. Good question. You know, I don't know. Maybe it's, I mean, you know, I just wouldn't have, you know, thought that this would be a situation.
Mm-hmm.
I never would have thought this would be a situation. But as it turned out to be, the way it looks, it's mighty, mighty fishy to me that you have all of a sudden a half white, half black royalty. Megan, may I call her name?
Mm-hmm.
And then Harry, since he's married to her with the black in her, you know, maybe it's the white side of her. Have you ever thought about that? I mean, maybe, I'm serious. Uh-uh. Maybe it's the white side of her that they're not wanting to accept. And, you know.
Trust me. I feel confident. I'm not in the castle. Uh-huh. Or whatever. I guess is what they call it. But I'm not there. But I have a strong feeling that ain't got nothing to do. Well, and because if you look, you don't see nothing black around there.
Yeah.
I'm not saying they need to just have a whole bunch of Negroes in the castle or in the palace, but I'm saying when you have an old institution,
you don't
like,
have any black servers or anything.
I'm sure they got plenty of those, yeah. And janitors. I'm sure they're somewhere in there.
But the blacks are to serve and not to be served.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I don't know.
Think about it. Whenever you have something, and you know, whenever you have something that old and that white, for that long, they are stuck in their ways. Mm. Queen's been around a long time, well before, you know, the civil rights. So, I'm just saying.
Yeah. Well, this is mighty strange, folks. I don't know. What do you think? Should it be taken this far? As far as a race thing here?
Mm-hmm.
And I know some babies may say, well, you already know what it is, Bob. You've been around here. Yeah, but, you know, some change. And you would like to think that it's not that anymore. You want to give it an opportunity not to think that that's it anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what I'm doing. You know, so this is a new time. This is a new day. This is a new age we're living in. We're living in the time to where everybody's, you know, getting together, white, black, or whatever. So is this the point, or is this the situation in the royal house that they don't want the black half of her in the mix?
I'm gonna be straight up. I think it's pretty obvious, at least to me, that that's what's going on. Because
think of something else it could be besides racism.
There's nothing. Like, I mean, you're like, you know, I hadn't seen it. It's not like she's up in there turning stuff around and trying to fry chicken, you know.
Well, I mean, it doesn't matter, but maybe Megan got up in there and disrespected the queen somehow, or disrespect the way things are done. She wants to change things around from the way it's done rather than just moving in and just settling down and just enjoying the life that she's in.
I don't believe that at all.
Maybe she's disturbing the whole situation.
Here's the thing. With Harry coming in and marrying a person like this, I think I'm pretty sure, you know, they'd have a conversation about the traditions of the whole thing. You know? And I can easily see, you know, them having a problem with the bloodline. Because you know how serious stuff with the bloodline of the royal family not being, you know, tainted, if you want to use that word or whatever.
All blood is tainted if you want to look at it as far as sin is concerned. But, you know,
they're not looking at that though.
Okay, black, white, whatever, it's all the same blood.
To be real, again,
if you're going to get a blood transfusion, you don't know where you're getting your blood from.
Yeah.
You know, it's all the same. There's no black blood, white blood, yellow blood, and all that kind of stuff. So Oh, but, you know, royal blood.
So to your question again, mm-hmm. I don't think it's any other thing that could be brought up as a problem. Now, if y'all can think of something, feel free to call in and let us know.
Yeah, I mean, maybe it's a sports issue. Maybe it's bringing too much American stuff into the royal family. Maybe, I don't know, maybe it's the food issue. Mm-hmm. Maybe she wants some chitterlings. Chitlins or something. I don't know. I'm just saying. You know, but...
Do you want me to read? There's a lot of comments coming in. Okay, just all right, yeah.
GKP, what does he say? Y'all already know who it is. But Good morning, GKP. Yes.
Yes, I got you. And then Jay also says, and in headlines today, which is his tradition there. Uh-huh. Frankie, good morning. Good Tuesday morning to you.
You skipped all over Brant. Brant Morrison, good morning to you.
Okay, well, just know it's not on my pad. I will never skip no.
You reading from the other...
It's another one?
Are you reading from the, what do you call it? The...
No, I'm not reading from a watch
book. Okay, watch book. Okay, go ahead.
Same thing.
Okay, like. Go ahead.
But whatever I don't read, let me know, and then you can read that.
Kelly says, good morning before GKP. Go ahead.
Mm-hmm. Frankie said, good morning. Andre Becton says, it's the oldest racist thing in there with the USA. And dude willing to separate all that racist stuff to keep his wife instead of the money.
Wow.
And that's a lot of money.
Yeah.
They talk about the fortune like being around $88 billion. Mm. Billion. Not million. Billion. Mm-hmm. With the royal family. Jet. So he changed his name there. He says, Harry don't want them folks to kill his wife. Like they did his mom.
Oh, come on, Jet. Kill this woman like they killed his mom? Do you think they killed his mom? I don't think they would go that far. Is it really that bad in white in America, in the world today?
Well, now, with his mother... That wasn't because of race. But I will say this.
Well, talking about the car accident.
Yeah, yeah. There were people that literally and still believe that was an intentional thing.
Intentional, why?
Harry said, and I want to find that clip. I'm surprised this news clip didn't play it.
Okay.
They played some of that press conference. But Harry said he literally, and it was the biggest quote I took from it. Mm. He said, I don't want my family to be involved. Same mess that had his mother killed was the reason for his mother's death. That is a huge statement for him to make.
It really is.
So it really is. Who knows what he's alluding to.
Now, did you know that he sent her already to Canada to get away from all of that? And he's probably joined her by now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he has sent her on away from before they even got their hands on her. What do you think this is? Wow, this is, folks, this is really big. Wow, I didn't think it would lead to all of this. I mean, really? Is skin color really that serious, folks? I mean, wow. With some people, not all white people or other people feel this way. It's just a few. Well, a little more than a few. But does it still have to be this way today?
That could be. It definitely doesn't have to.
But I mean, I don't get it though. I do not get it because of a skin color. I mean, why? What's wrong with my brown skin? What's wrong with his white skin? What's the problem? I mean, we all have the same blood. We all have the same... we all live in the same world. I mean, nobody can just say, I don't want to be here anymore and just... You're here. So, I mean... What makes you think brown, black, white, Japanese, no knees? I mean, what makes you think that because of who you are and your skin color, that you rule the world? And that other people don't matter. I don't get that. Folks, help me to understand, please. Somebody leave me some comments or a phone call. What is going on with this Meghan and Harry, Your Highness situation? Really, what do you think is really going on? Is there something that we don't know that you read into and that you know and realize that maybe we're not getting? Maybe we're not getting the point. You know we can misunderstand it. So do you think this is one of those cases that we're misunderstanding Your Highness and the royal family, the prince? 901-213-6020. Andre said, you already read that, right, Josh? What Andre said?
I read one of them.
Andre Becton?
I know he's left several. I would like
after Jet, as old as you are, Bob, have you ever seen any color in a lead position over there?
To be honest.
No. Race is... and has a great deal to do with it. Okay, thank you, Andre.
And the next one is, next few is Andre as well.
Okay.
He said, it's not half and half. If you have 1 ounce of black blood, you are black. It's an unwritten rule, you're black.
I don't think it's the blood, though, folks. I think we're being misled in the seed here. I understand where you're coming from. Yeah. I think it's just the skin color. The blood is the same.
Well, look, we know that. I don't think anybody's taking that literally.
Okay.
Because all of that. That's why I don't want to dive too deep into that. Hopefully, most people should know that. But I think the thing is, her parents. She's got one black parent. So
right.
But because look, I'm gonna be honest with you. Until folks told me she was black, I had no clue whatsoever. So that's a whole nother thing. But anyway, I get what you're saying. Now, Andre says again, but that's not the case. It would be nice, but the world has not caught up with your progression. Harry the Queen by marrying Meghan.
So what he's saying is the Queen didn't want him to marry her. So, but he went ahead anyway and against the Queen's wishes.
And these are assumptions. Now, Andre also says, yes, it's that serious. This was how the world was made. Capital letters. So okay. I appreciate that. Frankie then said, do you remember that Princess Diana was dating / engaged to a foreigner when she was killed? I believe he was from the Middle East. Wow.
Wow.
Now, I was too young when that was going on.
Frankie.
Wow. I remember that in the news, though. But wow. Now, that's an interesting thought also.
That is an interesting thought.
And I know we got another topic to get to in a little bit here.
Yeah.
What's up, Greg? Greg good just morning. Coming in.
Yeah, Greg.
But look, it's very telling to me for Harry to sit there and say he does not want the same thing to happen to Meghan that happened to his mother, which was Princess Diana. Why would he say that? Unless,
He knew something or something's going on.
Yeah.
Or something was about to go down and he didn't want it to happen, and that type of thing.
And then think about it again. Nobody thinks that the Diana situation was a murder. At least that wasn't what put out there. It was a car accident.
Yeah.
But
there was a little suspicion, but
there's still conspiracy theories about that.
Yeah.
So, but what I'm saying is, for the son to sit here and say that almost confirms something, don't you think? I don't know if he did that on purpose or not. He was speaking emotionally. But it's interesting.
Yeah, it is very interesting, folks. Do you think Harry and Meghan are overreacting here? Do you think they're overreacting? And for her to just all of a sudden out of from over in that situation, and she's in Canada well ahead of him. She went ahead of him to get the situation done, take care of the situation in Canada. Do you think she'll be going back?
No, no. Excuse me.
Do you think she'll be going back there taking, or do you think she'll be taking a risk going back and something may happen to her? This is very disturbing. Very disturbing. And I hate to say it that way. She'll be taking a risk going back. Or do you think we're all overreacting to this? That none of this is the case. It's just that people are assuming that it has something to do with race. But the Queen is one of the nicest and most welcoming women you'll ever meet. The Queen eats chitlins and pork chops.
I doubt that severely. I think she will have you thrown out of the palace if you.
Well, let's say she didn't fry chicken, and sautéed it or baked it. Would that make a difference? I'm just saying, folks.
Yeah.
So I'm just saying. But anyway, Harry seems like he wants to get to the simple life. He wants to stay with his wife. He wants to enjoy life and his marriage.
And about now,
yeah.
Real quick before we keep going into that. Now, I got one more with Harry here. Audio.
Okay.
That goes to what I was talking about. Then we can keep going. All right.
Yeah. Take a listen to this, folks.
You know, my mom clearly taught me a certain set of values of which I will always try and uphold, despite the role and the job that sometimes that entails, if you know what I mean. But I think I will always protect my family, and now I have a family to protect. So everything that she went through and what happened to her is incredibly raw every single day, and that's not me being paranoid, that's just me not wanting a repeat of the past. And if anybody else knew what I knew, be it a father, be it a husband, be it anyone, you'd probably be doing exactly what I'm doing as well.
So that's interesting. There, he said, yeah. If anybody knew what he knew, they would be doing the same thing he's doing in this situation.
What does he know? I didn't hear the too much of it at the beginning. What was this?
Well, he's not going to say what he knows. So, you know, if it must be something to the point where he's not talking about it. But he said, the important thing I got there, he's like, if anybody knows what he knew about this situation, you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Before we read the comments there, that they would do the same thing in regards to their family. Right. Because his wife getting him out of there.
Yeah.
So, who knows what that means?
Wow. Okay. 901-213-6020. Andre makes another statement. What does he say?
I got him on here. Good morning, Greg. I think I said that already. Andre says, in the next 50 years, it's a chance that the Queen could be black because his children will be black as well.
Well, I don't think so now because they're no longer... position to the throne.
I guess
by leaving like this,
that makes you wonder.
He's given up his position in the royal family.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that means they'll skip over him and his family. I assume.
Kelly says, it was something, Mr. Bob, for her to catch the first thing smoking to Canada.
I'm telling you. I am telling you.
Hey, look, if you hear Harry talk, it seems like he was the one that kind of pushed that, to be honest with you. Yeah. It's him saying what he's saying now. Uh-huh. He's like, hey, you get out of here. Why? Why does she have to run?
Well, probably
with a child, too. They like took off.
Yeah, but this all sounds like an assassination attempt.
I mean,
don't it? It's really weird. Strange.
It does.
I mean, wow. Do you think they'll go to Canada and pay somebody to hunt her down?
Now, Brant Morrison with an interesting comment here. He says, I don't think it's because she is black, but I do think it's because she wasn't 100% white. They will never risk the crown being passed down to someone who isn't white. Right okay. or wrong.
All right. So what is it then? If she's half black, so she's not all white.
Now,
but what is she? Okay, go ahead. I'm sorry.
All right. Right or wrong, that's how it's always been fit for the royal family. Now, look. You know, like I said, we can get into some of the semantics about white, black, and all that stuff.
Yeah.
But I do think it's a good point Brant brings up there.
Well, see, I don't think white people have anything to do with this. I don't think black people have anything to do with this. I think this is just something coming out of the royal palace. And they're choosing to say, okay, America, black and white are trying to get over their issues as far as black and white. But all of this time, everybody respected the princes and the royal palace and everything like that. And now we find out that it is the cat is running loose in the royal palace. Nobody even probably thought that it was this way.
But what does that mean? What does that mean? I don't understand.
Well, like, it means that the United States is trying to get over racism. All right, but then you find out that the royal palace is not.
Yeah.
It's just as real and strong there that it is probably in America.
Yeah, yeah, okay. I get that.
You know, and now it's all coming out.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
You know, so, wow. You'll never know where you'll find it, folks. And when you least expect it to be something,
okay.
Then it turns out to be something. And it throws you way off guard.
Now, I'm going to tell you, look, and I know a lot of people were surprised by this whole thing, but not me. Now, look, it's not like I spent a bunch of time studying the palace or anything, so I'm far from an expert, but this whole thing, to me, does not surprise me.
Okay.
Because, once again, whenever you have an old institution like that, that does not change. One thing about them, they're not going to change for nobody, as evident here. They have old ways and old values that they stick to, no matter what. And I think that's part of it. Well, they want their bloodline for the throne, as ridiculous as it may sound, to be as pure, driven,
okay.
driven snow-wise as possible when it comes to 100% us.
But... Now, let's look at it on the other hand. How many black women are out there that are saying, that Negro, she left us and went out there and tried to marry the royalties?
No, ain't no women saying that. It's men.
Hey, black men or whatever.
It's black men saying that.
You know, saying,
the women actually were congratulating.
Oh, yeah. She went to the white guy, tried to marry the royalty and get away from us, her black, half black self. And didn't want anything to do with the black man, you know, and that type of thing. Do you think some people are really saying that stuff today? I mean,
they were saying that before this. They were saying that before this happened. And look, I'm like this, man, and this is just me though. But I'm curious what y'all think about it too. And this whole situation, all of the stuff we're talking about, you. Hey, but before you go into that, you can also call into the show. We hadn't actually brought this up at all.
Yeah.
But 901-213-6020.
Yeah.
If you want to call in to the show and join the conversation, or, what do you think? How do you feel about what's going on with this?
Or you can continue to leave your comments.
You can do both.
Either one or both.
Yeah.
but I'm this is... To me, I'm saying this is more disturbing to you than you really thought it would be? It's disturbing to me to find this situation out, the way it's going. You know, the way this whole thing is going. I am very disturbed, and I would have never thought.
Now, and again, this is coming from us. And I know, at least for me, I have never cared. This is not a hatred or anything, but this, you know, I just have never cared about the royal family or the obsession.
Well, let's say you never cared, or you just never studied into them.
Well, that, and I just never, like, when I see it on the news, right, I just didn't have an interest.
No.
In the obsession that a lot of people had in the prince's relationships with women and the queen and what they were doing. I'm like, it is what it is.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure they're fine. You know, I'm like, I wish them well.
Yeah.
But this situation has caught my interest. Looking at the way it's going on, and it has you wondering about the way they do things.
Yeah. Well, I guess, no black royalty to the top of the line anyway, so let's look at it that way.
Okay.
So the throne has been, well, they both have been dethroned. He's given up his position.
Yeah.
And so Derek can, walking away. So any kids they have together or whatever, or, can never be a part of the royal family.
And now let me read
any
this.
Position.
Brad Morris is laughing. He said, man, that's funny. I'm laughing so hard. Now, he may be laughing when we talk about black men, what they were saying. But Greg says, maybe it's simply because the new world couple don't want to conform to strict, stuck-up old ways. Meghan still wants to act and was told, nope, nope, nope.
What does he mean, still want to act, nope, nope, nope?
Well, I mean, she was told no. But she's an actor.
Oh, okay, like, okay.
That's what she does. That's what she's done leading into this.
So she was told no acting?
Yes. I don't know that. Now, according to Harry, before he hits with the nothing burger, which I see the big nothing burger with cheese on there.
Greg, you got to put the pickles and everything on there now.
This
is a real burger here.
Harry said, look, I don't want to happen to Meghan what happened to my mother, which was Princess Diana. What does that mean? Who knows?
Yeah.
There's no way to know, really, unless he decides to come out and say what he's talking about.
Yeah. Greg, what do you mean a big nothing burger? I mean, I think I know what you mean. You don't think this is as real as it seemed to us or to anybody else that's making comments on this situation, or you just don't think it has anything to do with racism? You think we're making a big deal out of every time we turn around, it's racism. Black people need to get over it and all that other kind of stuff. It's just that you feel it's just that they wanted to be in Canada in the first place. They didn't want to stay in the situation they were in. It all boils down to that, and it has nothing to do with racism.
Now, here's the thing. Harry and Meghan have never said anything about racism.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not the case, but, and look, I don't expect them to come out and say, hey, my family's racist. But, it's just people reading in between the lines. Now, whether they're right or wrong.
Greg Sam's saying, I don't care.
Whether they're right or wrong is is up, just to finish, is up for interpretation.
So. Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, that's the situation on that. You can continue to leave your comments on this as well as any other questions or comments on this whole situation. Wow, this is a big deal, folks. Andre says, what did he say?
Frankie says, Harry's children would probably never reach the throne, all because of William's children. That's the other prince. William's children are ahead of Harry's children.
Well,
hey, let me. I didn't finish it yet.
Okay.
Unless you're trying to skip to something.
No. I was just yawning.
Okay. Because of all of William's children are ahead of Harry's children in line to the throne.
Well, about it. I mean, Harry has children.
Mm-hmm.
He has kids. Okay, William don't have any kids by her, so they don't have any kids yet. So they're well ahead. By the time they do probably have kids and they grow up, they're probably these kids. If they had stayed in the royal line, they
now, who's talking about don't have kids.
Harry.
No. Listen, Harry's got kids. That's what I'm saying.
You said William. William's children.
Yeah.
William have children. Harry don't have kids.
Harry does have kids. That's why she said.
Well, he don't have kids with her.
Yeah, they're babies. But yeah, she does have kids.
I thought those were only his kids. I thought he had four kids.
No, she's been pregnant, I think, at least twice.
Really?
Yeah, that's been okay, in the news. Well,
he's moving, ain't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, I don't know. I just wasn't following it.
Either, that's my point. You
know, so
that's why I said children. But I know I saw when she's pregnant because they put it all over the news.
Oh, okay. I heard something about that, yeah. But I mean, it's still small kids, though. I mean, where's
William? And that's Frankie's point.
Yeah, where's William's kids, though? Are they in their 20s, 30s?
Again, I guess. But she said William's children are ahead of Harry's.
So okay. Yeah. All right. So, okay, there you go.
Yeah. Now, real quick, last one is here. Andre, who's really been in the conversation. I appreciate that. Mm-hmm. He says Diana's was married to Harry's father. She was dating an African. Oh, Lord.
His mother?
According to Andre, yeah.
Was dating an African? Wow. What is it about letting the Africans and dark skin and black folks in the royal line? I mean, was somebody trying to sneak them in or something? I mean, Diana wanted to marry an African, and then here's Harry, a half-black. He trying to sneak it in, but he, you know, tried to subtly sneak it in. Halfway. Let me get some in here. I'm just saying, folks.
Maybe they want the kids to play sports, you know.
This is crazy. If this is the case here. 901-213-6020. Diana. She was dating an African. Boy, this is really turning into something I really didn't see. Well, we're going to take a quick break here, Josh. And when we come back, boy, we got something to talk about next. Boy, I tell you don't want to miss this. We'll be back after this. You're listening to Talk Back Live with Bob
and Josh.
And it's now 9. What is it? 06?
No, 9.
9 o'clock. 9 o'clock. It is 9 a.m. Central Time. A very pleasant good morning to you on a Tuesday morning. A lot of stuff still to talk about, folks. We'll be back after this.
Talking about current events and topics that matter.
This is Sergeant Chris Richardson of the Tennessee Highway Patrol. Pedestrian safety is a two-way street. Both drivers and walkers need to do their part to keep roads safe. When you're walking, remember, the drivers may not always see you, so remember to use these tips to continue to walk safe. Wear black clothes, always use crosswalks and obey signs. Lights and reflectors should be used. And finally, keep alert and do not walk distracted. This message brought to you by the Tennessee Highway Patrol.
CJU's Appliances, located at 3530 Jackson Avenue here in Memphis, Tennessee. Call them at 901-487-7882. CJU's Appliances have the best prices in town. Sales and service, heating and air. Also, the best appliances you'll find anywhere in the Mid-South. Refrigerators, microwave stoves, washers and dryers, deep freezers, dishwashers, whatever you need in used appliances. And folks, I'm telling you, they're the best used appliances anywhere you'll find. That's CJ Used Appliances, 3530 Jackson Avenue. All appliances come with warranty. You can call them at 901-487-7882. Again, 901-487-7882. CJ Used Appliances.
See Graphics Printing, located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis, a complete print shop for all your printing needs. They do it all. Color copy, resumes, funeral programs, rubber stamps, full-color business cards, wedding and graduation invitations, and more. 30-plus years of quality work and service. They're open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m., located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis, Tennessee, 901-345-9294. See Graphics Printing.
Max Back Taxes, 4422 Yale Road here in Memphis, Tennessee, 901-382-1414. Get the maximum back on your taxes. It is now tax season. 15 years in business. Precise, professional, and honest. Hey, you need to go by Max Back Taxes, 4422 Yale Road. Call 901-382-1414 and talk to Tamara. Get the maximum back on your taxes with Max Back Taxes.
You're listening to Talk Back Live with Bob and Josh. Talking about current events and topics that matter. Call in now, 901-213-6020. 901-213-6020. Now, here's Bob and Josh.
All right, and welcome back to the show. Talk Back Live with Bob
and Josh.
And it's 9:04, 4 minutes past the hour of 9 o'clock Central Time. And a very pleasant good morning to you on a Tuesday morning. And talking about Max Back Taxes, you go there with Tamara Henderson. What is it? 4422 Yale Road. Go there and get your taxes done with Max Back Taxes. Get the maximum back for your taxes. Get a free massage.
Matter of fact, best thing you can do, man. We all know tax season. It can get you stressed out, man. Get your taxes. Where can I get them done? How can I get them done?
Yeah.
Am I going to be audited? Are they stealing all my money? All of that stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, will I get a refund? Well, look, while they're working all that out for you, you can get a free full body massage right there at Max Back Taxes by the professionals there.
And while you're getting relaxed and laid back with the massage, then you get up and go back in there and then sign on the dotted line to where you're getting the back on your taxes.
Yes, sir.
Max Back Taxes, 4422 Yale Road. Go by and see them today.
Contact, once again, for Henderson. Yes. 901-382-1414. Also, there's a website, www.maxbacktaxes.com. And you can see all this on the screen right there. 18 years of experience when it comes to giving you the maximum back on your taxes.
All right. And if you need some printing work done, you got some things that need to be done as far as printing it's concerned, and you need to display it, need it displayed in a beautiful and professional way, you need to go and see the good people at C Graphics Printing, located 890 East Range Road, 30 plus years of quality work and service. That's C Graphics Printing, and these businesses are all black owned businesses, and so you go by C Graphics as well. And see, and the good people down at C Graphics Printing, 890 East Range Road, 30 plus years of quality work and service. And they do all kinds of printing work. Josh?
Yes, sir. Color copies, resumes, funeral programs,
rubber stamps, full color business cards, weddings and graduations, invitations, and all kinds of other copies as well. It says color copies.
You read them all.
Resumes as well. Flyers, posters. There you go. And a whole lot more. Again, 30 plus years. Eddie and the good people have been there. 890 East Range Road. C Graphics Printing. They've been there for 30 years plus. 30 years plus. It's probably about 36 years now. And they hadn't been there all that time for nothing, folks. And so that means they've done some good work and they're still doing good work. Call them today, 901-345-9294. See graphics. Printing. All right. And we welcome you back to the show. Talk Back Live with Bob.
And Josh.
And 908, 8 minutes past the hour of 8 o'clock Central Time. And looking at some of your comments that we were reading before the break, Andre says Diana was married to Harry's dad. He was dating an African.
Yeah, she was dating an African.
She was dating an African. Mm-hmm. Andre says, again, facts. Greg says, what does Greg say?
He says that guy was the son of an Egyptian billionaire, the guy that was dating Diana. He died in the crash as well. Mm. Fayed was his name or something like that, says Greg.
So he died in the crash as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, wow.
That took them both.
I guess some people say they intended to take them both there.
That goes into the conspiracies.
Oh, wow.
Jed says, I don't trust none of them anyway. How the you married and you a queen, but your husband ain't no king? Yeah, he's not. And they don't even let him talk.
Oh, come on, Jet.
He said he'd be so quiet, I bet most folks think he's dead. Oh, man.
I didn't know she got a husband? She had a husband?
Yeah, he's a, yeah.
Oh. Wow. So something else is going on here. We need to really, we need to dig a little deeper into this royal thing that's going on.
And, do we really?
No, I mean, you know, Meghan and Harry is starting to bring some things out here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Well, I mean, this stuff's been, but I understand what you mean.
Well, we can see it.
Yeah, yeah. Pulling the veil back. Yeah.
I mean, Jet says, you know, quiet.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Okay, yeah, okay. All right. Who is that? Darnell says, Darnell is watching. Thanks, Darnell.
Yes, sir.
Jet said, Dottie, what is that?
Fayed. He's saying the name of the guy. I think he's trying to say but hey,
see what? I mean, I think he's talking about me, Josh.
I don't know.
What do you mean, see?
I don't know. But okay.
But anyway,
I know we have another topic I want to get to. If we
well, can. Yes, yeah. Yes, we do. What in the what's going on with this, Josh?
Well, it depends on, I guess, your perspective, man. So
I don't know. Folks, are there certain things that you would return and give back, or certain thing, or are there certain things that you will not return and give back to people or to anyone? Over $40,000 was found in donated furniture.
Mm-hmm.
If you bought something from, what is it? The thrift store.
Mm-hmm.
If you bought something from the thrift. Okay. If you bought something from the thrift store, okay, and you find out later on, okay, you know, some strange way you found out that is a lot of money involved in the furniture or in a briefcase or luggage or some cloth bag or something you found, and you know, you found it, and then there's a lot of money involved in it. $40,000 worth, or $100,000 worth, or $500,000 worth of money. What would you do with it? Would you return the $40,000, you return the $500,000 and keep the $40,000?
Before we, I want to be specific here.
Yeah.
You know, because, you know, like I said, even though it's the same principle, but I want to get into the story of what it is.
Yeah.
So that they know what you're talking about. But Dodi Fayed. Greg said he looked it up and found the name of the guy.
Okay.
So anyway, here's on this next story we're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
$40,000. What would you do if you were this guy? Now, this guy, I'm going to play the story for y'all in a second here. Mm-hmm. But he bought a couch from a thrift store.
Yeah.
And in the couch cushions, he's like, man, this thing ain't too comfortable. Maybe I need to unzip this thing and see if I need to do some adjusting with the cushion. And he found a lot more cushion than he was expecting. Yeah. So I'm going to play the story and get y'all to listen. And be right back.
Yeah.
All right, so I'll go ahead and play it.
Yeah, go ahead.
And whatever else is going on.
We'll... Folks, we'll be back at phone number 901-213-6020.
Good grief.
Yeah. You can call us or you can leave your comment. Take a listen to this.
It still boggles my mind every so often.
Howard Kirby likes to shop at the Habitat for Humanity Restore in Owosso. Last month, he purchased a couch for his man cave. And this weekend, he made a shocking discovery. It was filled with thousands of dollars in cash.
Still have to pinch myself to make sure I'm not dreaming or something. And
Kirby says that he had this ottoman for a few weeks before noticing that it was uncomfortable. And that's when his daughter decided to open it up.
And then she started pulling out this.
Oh, my goodness.
A total of $43,170 was found in the ottoman cushion. But Kirby says he didn't feel right keeping the money, so he reached out to the Restore to find out who had donated the couch. Turns out it was Kim Fouth Newberry. The couch originally belonged to her grandfather, and he died last year.
This is just crazy.
Today, the Restore held a big surprise for Fouth Newberry. To give back every dollar found in the cushion.
Why he's got money in cushions? I don't know.
Complete that's awesome. Really? Like, we talked about that.
Kirby says an attorney told him that he had no legal obligation to give the money back, but he felt like he had to morally. And that's something that Rick Merling, the store manager, thinks is heartwarming.
Just doing the right thing. To me, this is someone who, in spite of what they're going through, in spite of their own needs, has said, I'm just going to do the right thing.
Kirby says he could have used the money, but he feels better knowing that the money is with the rightful owner.
I've heard it done so many other times, and I always thought, what would I do if that ever happened? Now I don't.
And it makes me feel good.
In Owosso, Rachel McCrary, WNEM, TV5.
Okay, what do you think? Would you have given the money back? Or do you think anybody would have given the money back? Do you think most people would give money back like that in a situation? Or you think most people would keep it? Finders, what does it say? Finders keepers, losers weepers. That's what some people say.
Hey.
Okay, so.
You know what gets on my nerves about this? Well, and I heard it earlier, and I hear it again. Why is there, and maybe I'm wrong. See, y'all tell me if I'm wrong. But this thought that he did the right thing. It's good to know people will just do the right thing. What is the right thing? Is there a rule book that says, hey, I bought a couch that had money in the cushions, so the right thing to do is to send it back to the store? Where is that a rule?
I mean,
is that a normal thing?
Well,
you bought the couch, you don't know who it belongs to.
Right? I mean, once you buy something, once you purchase something, it becomes your possession. And then the saying is that everything that comes with it is your possession.
Yeah.
Okay, let's say you go to a thrift store.
Yeah. Because that's what this was. It was a thrift
store. And you buy a couch. Mm-hmm. And it comes along with, extra pillows. You know the big extra pillows that sit on the couch besides the regular cushion things or that, whatever it is. Uh-huh. You get extra pillows that come with it, right? They match the couch, but it don't look like they came with the couch. Mm-hmm. But it's not the original pillows, but they put them on there anyway. Should you keep those pillows just because they didn't come with the couch? Or they're not the ones that belong with the couch? Or should you give them pillows back to the store? Okay? Some people say that what you find and whatever comes or whatever you buy it becomes yours. Everything therein belongs to you now.
Yeah.
So it's a fact. If a person gives, okay, yeah, look at it like this now. If this lady or whatever, this guy or whoever gave the couch to the thrift store,
mm-hmm.
they gave it to the thrift store in good faith, and when they gave it away, they gave the money away too, or was it, were they not thinking at the time, and therefore, okay, they lost their money. Do they have the right to come back and say, okay, we gave you a couch, but we left our money in the couch? Do they have the right to come back? And does the thrift store have the right now, since it belongs to them, they've signed it over to them and said, we give it to you. And can the thrift store even say, everything that is on that couch or whatever was in that couch mm-hmm. is now in our possession? It belongs to us. Okay, let's say Jet gives me, a pair of his socks or something. And, they're dirty socks. But yet at the same time, he didn't realize the night before, he decided that he's going to hide, maybe $10,000 down in there and hide it from someone and then take it out in the morning. But he forgot. And he gave me his dirty socks with the $10,000. Now, once he's given me his dirty socks,
some sock, yeah.
Now, do I have to, then I discover there's $10,000 in there.
Uh-huh.
Do I have to give Jet the $10,000 back and keep his dirty socks?
Well,
why is it that I have to keep his dirty socks but give his $10,000 back?
Well, I'm going to tell you this. If I find $10,000 in Jet's dirty socks, I would wash the socks and give them back. Look, I mean, with $10,000 in there, I think it's worth, I'll go ahead and wash them and give you your socks back, but I'm keeping this money. Well, matter of fact, forget the socks. I might throw the socks away, especially if they're dirty.
I mean, what I'm saying is, I wouldn't do anything with the socks. All I'm saying is, if $10,000 come in the socks, I have the right to keep it since it was given to me and that type of thing. Now it's given to me. It's in my possession. He has relinquished. He has given away the socks.
Mm-hmm.
He no longer wants them, and now they belong to me. So does that mean everything that came along with the socks, the dirt and everything, if I have to accept the dirt, is why is it so strange that I can't accept the $10,000?
That's a thought.
Okay.
That's a thought.
All right. Okay. So, even though he forgot about it or whatever the case may be, but has he given away something here that he can no longer get back? Even though I look and I find over the $10,000 there, but it's after the fact that it's been given to me.
Mm-hmm. That's okay. True.
Did he give to me the $10,000 or did he give to me the dirty socks?
Now look,
did he give both to me? Do I have the right to keep it? So this is the situation here.
That's a good question.
Okay.
Now there's some people that gave some different answers here. Greg says, I would have turned in the $6 I found. So he would have went back to the store with $6 of the 40 plus thousand.
Greg, that don't make sense. That don't make sense. So if you take the $6 back, they're gonna know that there was more than that, Greg.
Yeah.
And then the people are gonna come back. Now you've started something, at least saying, okay, there was something in the pillow. It mm-hmm. was $6. Then the people that owned it gonna say, okay, they brought $6 back and they took and said, hey, we'll give the $6 to the owner. The owners come over and say, no. Come to think of it, it was $40,000 a can of worms for them to even give that back. Or should you just leave it alone and just keep the $40,000?
Y'all on a trip.
Okay. Brent says, I'm keeping it.
Yes. And right before that, Frankie says he did a great thing. Talking about that old man. But I would have definitely kept the money.
Okay, Frankie, where's your money now since you bought the couch? Is it legally, technically, your money.
And she gave an answer to that a little bit further down.
Okay, no, just read out.
No, I am. Okay. I was just letting you know.
Okay.
Yeah, but so Greg says, in a situation like that, I would have kept the money. Now, if I had bought the couch straight from the person, then I may have considered giving the money back. So basically, if it was a one-on-one deal, instead of the store being the in-between.
Right, right. So it's gone through several changes here.
Yeah, yeah. Like if I get that. Like if I knew the person and they gave me that, they sold me that couch or whatever, and I find that money, it would be kind of weird. I would feel a little more weird than I would if it was, I know you're reading ahead because I wanted to read that for it. Cause it's,
yeah,
it's,
go no, I hadn't read it. Go ahead. Okay.
But it's, I would feel a little more weird if, you know, let's say it's my neighbor or something.
Yeah.
And I buy it and I find all this money. I'm like, man, I can't keep this from dude, can I? Or can you?
Well, I mean, has your neighbor said anything about it? Or do you think your neighbor later on may say, hey, the couch we gave you 3 weeks ago, man, you know, we've got $40,000 in one of those pillows. I forgot to tell you that. You know, I've got to mention, can I get my $40,000 back?
That's quite a forget.
I mean, you know, yeah. I mean, but here's the problem with that.
Yeah.
Here's the problem with that. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's say there was $40,000 in there.
Okay.
If this guy comes over and say, okay, I gave you a couch 3-4 weeks ago. It was $40,000 in one of the pillows.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Who to say that he's lying or he's telling the truth? Mm-hmm. Because, I mean, let's say, for instance, if you look in the pillow and you don't find $40,000 in none of the pillows, he can say, okay, I left $40,000 in this pillow. Where is it? Now, and according to him, you didn't find the $40,000. There's no $40,000 in there now once he starts complaining. So now are you gonna have to come up with $40,000 and give to this guy since he said he gave it to you with $40,000 in there, and then you look at it, there's nothing there, and you've never seen $40,000 in that couch. So there was nothing in there. Now he's claiming that he had $40,000 in the couch. Mm-hmm. You're gonna have to come up with it. Okay? If a person gives away $40,000 and you get the $40,000 and it's there, you know it's there.
Situation to come.
And he comes and now, well.
Oh, honestly, well, I mean.
And he comes and say, okay, I left $40,000 and you know it's there. Should you give it back? This is not the same situation as the guy buying the couch and finding $40,000 and therefore nobody's asking for it.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Nobody's asking for it. So, therefore, he's found $40,000. Okay, here's the point. Should he do it? And some people say, legally, he should do it. What do you mean, legally? What makes that legal for him to give $40,000 back in the couch that he bought? What makes that legal? Is it legal that he bought it and whatever he bought belongs to him?
Mm-hmm.
If he bought the couch, whatever comes along with the couch, the trash, the stuff is in the couch, the dirty stuff, the pennies or whatever you have to sweep out of the couch or vacuum or whatever, all that came. They didn't complain about the trash, did they?
True.
All right. So, but now they want to complain about the $40,000. But nobody said anything to him about it. Should he just have kept it? The legal thing was he bought it. Legally, did it belong to him? Yes or no? Did the money legally belong to the guy that bought the couch? Or morally, so some people say, he did the right thing because he knew that money didn't belong to him. Or did it belong to him when he purchased the couch? That's the question.
That's a lot of questions. But I think it's a lot of situations.
Legally, when you buy something, it everything that's a part of that comes with it, right?
Mm-hmm.
When you buy a brand new couch, a living room set, or in most cases, you know, well, what I've said, You have to tear the plastic off of the love seat in the couch or the chair. You have to tear the plastic off. They don't ask you. They don't ask for the plastic back, do they?
No.
I mean, they're going to tell you that's yours. You throw it away yourself. You find somewhere to dispose of it.
But is it like those old mattresses? You remember when you tear this tag off, you broke the law.
Yeah, well, I don't know.
So you take this money out.
But, I mean, you know, things you buy are going to have plastic around it. Even mattresses and box springs and all that kind of stuff, you know, they come in the plastic. So, I mean, do they ask for the plastic back? No, they don't. They say it's yours. All that junk is yours. The plastic and, you know, the new mattress and new love seat, couch, whatever.
Okay,
all that belongs to you. They don't ask for that back. Why do they ask for the money back?
That's a thought.
Okay.
And
some people say morally, it's the right thing to do because the money didn't belong to you.
Now, that's ridiculous. That's what I'm saying. I can't stand.
Look at it now. Did the money belong to him?
No.
Okay, morally, so he know it didn't belong to him. It's not his.
Well, look.
Is he stealing it?
No.
Okay, he know it's not his, so what is he doing with it then?
Here's the thing.
Why is he keeping it?
The difference to me is, let's say it was a wallet found in there, okay?
Okay.
And I'm going to read a couple more of these in a minute, but okay. Let's say it was a wallet found in one of the Kutchers, right?
Right.
It's got identification in it. You know whose it is.
Right.
That is wrong to keep that wallet and to keep the money in
it. Now
you wallet.
Know whose it is. Okay.
Exactly. But if you buy a couch, let's say, you know, it's not personal like Greg was talking here from a neighbor or something, mm-hmm. but you buy it from a thrift store, you don't know who had it before you. Mm-hmm. You buy that thing, that's your money.
Okay.
It don't matter whose it is before then, it is yours. Okay. Because I'm not finna go all over town peddling $40,000 because guess what? You're going to be a fool and the first person you run into is going to take that money.
Mm.
So it's your money. I don't like when people sit up here with the fake morality.
Mm.
People talk about all this, you know, fake mess. No, that's not moral. That's halfway foolish. Now, I'm not going to say what this guy did was foolish.
Mm-hmm.
Because if he felt he wanted to do that, that's on him.
That was his conviction.
That was his conviction to do so. Hey, and look, it ended up back with the family.
Yeah.
They didn't know their grandfather kept money. Who knows why he was hiding money in the seat cushions?
Mm-hmm.
That's a whole other thing. You know, I saw in the comments of that video.
Yeah.
It was funny. Somebody said, well, they just found out their grandfather was a drug dealer. I'm not going to say that.
Oh, come on. No, that's just the way, you know, that's just the way old people kept money back then.
Yeah, under mattresses.
They would hide it. You know, yeah. They would do stuff like that. And
that's a lot of money.
You know, and some people would bury it.
That's a lot of money.
And there's
though.
A lot of buried money out there that old people had that they didn't tell their loved ones,
yeah.
Hey, I buried some money out by the garden in the country and, you know, 50 years ago,
mm-hmm.
and I've been saving and digging it up and burying it, you know, and all of a sudden they left.
True.
They gone.
Yeah.
And all that money is left in the ground. No telling how much it is. Maybe $50,000, maybe $100,000 or more.
That's true. And you know what interests me, though?
So the people that buy the land.
Yeah.
They dig it up.
Yeah.
Do they take it back to the family they bought it from? There you go.
Yeah. Now, look, here's the thing. When I saw those bills, I don't know if you saw the video about it.
Yeah.
But before the show.
No, I didn't.
But those bills look crisp.
Mm.
Crisp.
Well,
had not been touched.
Well, they haven't. I mean, they probably haven't. Just bought brand new and put in there and, you know, just left the way they were.
They had the band around, like that white paper.
Right, right.
Yeah, right in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
So where do you get money with the wrap still on there? Yeah. I mean, did he rob a bank? I don't know. This money was so...
I mean, no, you can go to the bank and just tell them to leave the money as it is.
Get a money ring.
Yeah, get it, you know, just tell them, hey...
Keep the paper.
You know, I want $1,000 and one of them $1,000 rings or section or whatever, and give me $40,000. They're not going to take and give you $40,000.
Well, yeah.
They're going to put it in probably in $1,000 increments or whatever.
Hundreds, twenties.
Yeah, something 50s. Like that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that... you know, it wouldn't be, you know, and all that. It'd be easier to count.
Yeah. Yeah. I get that.
Yeah. That's the way they give me my money when I go to the bank.
Yeah. I'm just kidding. There you go.
Yeah. But anyway.
Big money.
Yeah. 901-213. Yeah, that is.
I just thought about that.
901-213-6020. Who called
I'm
me?
Trying to remember. It was several people, actually.
They called me Big Money. Yeah. A long time ago, wasn't it?
Yeah.
What was that here?
That was...
Oh, my goodness.
That was the Beale Street days.
Yeah.
But, okay. Well,
was it in Memphis at all?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, anyway.
So how long we been here.
Yeah.
GKP says, I'm sorry, but I don't want no man giving me his dirty socks.
Yeah.
LOL.
I understand what you're saying, but you know, hey, if I find a, give me a dirty sock, and I find a $10,000 in there, you know, hey, you know, I'll take the, I'll bear with it for a little while till I get the $10,000 out.
But oh, anyway, I got gain.
I understand what you're saying, but see, you could if I don't take the dirty socks Jet gave me, if I didn't take those socks, then I would have missed out on the $10,000.
Yeah, you missed out on all your blessings.
Sometimes we don't receive things that don't seem right, and we end up on our blessing, mm-hmm. you know, just because it don't look right, don't smell, walk white, talk white, and spit white. You know, then we want to get rid of it. And so then we miss our blessing.
Mm-hmm.
But in any way, I'm not saying just dirty socks are a blessing. Oh, my God, no. Anyway, Frankie says.
Man, that could preach right there.
Yes.
Let's see. Frankie says, I purchased the couch legally, and the Lord bless me.
Oh, Frankie.
Hallelujah.
Frankie, oh my God, hallelujah too.
No matter what you're dealing with, if God can get glory out of your situation.
There it is.
There you go. Frankie. I can't believe she added a hallelujah to that, too. Oh, my goodness. God, I purchased the couch legally, and the Lord blessed me. That was enough there, Frankie. And then you added hallelujah on the air. Oh, my God, Frankie. What's going on with you this morning? But anyway, what's next?
Greg says, inside a legally purchased item is now solely owned by the buyer.
Everything inside a legally purchased item is now solely owned to the buyer.
Mm-hmm.
Even though the other people lost it, they could be going through something, Greg. I mean, where are people's hearts these days? People could be going through something.
Now, Kelly sounds like he has a heart if I'm reading this right. He says, yeah, the money was his. It's the responsibility of the person selling the merchandise to check it top to bottom and left to right. That's a good point. But I understand what he did. So he's not hating on them giving the money back.
Okay.
But he says, hey, it's the person selling the item. It's your responsibility to check and make sure you ain't leaving nothing in there.
It's not yours that buy it, the person that buys it. To say, okay, I'm going to buy this couch, but let me check it over, see if there's $40,000
in here. No. Okay. It's up to the people selling it, which I agree. Yeah.
Rodney Fisher, thanks for watching.
What's up, Real News, Rodney? Yeah. Jay says, well, morally, I think he was a...
Stop it, Jay.
A fool.
GKP.
For giving the money back. He bought the couch. He bought the money. Period. Says GKP.
He bought the couch. He bought the money. He didn't buy the money.
He bought the money.
He bought the couch. He didn't buy the money, GKP. He didn't buy the money.
Well.
Period. What do you mean, period? He did not buy the money. He bought the couch. And then when he looked in there, he saw those people's money.
Mm-hmm.
Or was it their money now?
And once he saw that, if he was like Frankie, he'd be like this.
And I want you to know tonight that no matter what you're dealing with, God can get glory out of your situation.
Yeah. Okay. All right. GKP says Triple B. He want to call me Triple B. Big Bank Bob. That's a good one. That's a good one. I don't know. I might.
That's a t-shirt.
I might accept that. Yeah. I might accept that. Yeah. Big Bang Bob. Okay. All right. He also says what?
Not the preacher app, Josh. Yeah. Had to pull it out.
Yeah.
Will you find that money in the couch?
Oh, yeah.
Look, if you ain't never preached before. You going to preach now?
Yes, indeed. Yeah, like, talk and speak in tongues.
Yeah. Like mad.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
So, should you keep it or should you give it back? If you don't give it back, did you steal it? Are you a thief now? No, serious. Are you a thief now because you didn't give the money back? You know that money wasn't yours. You know you didn't save that money in that account. You know you didn't save that much money. So where does that money fit in with you? Are you now a thief? Did you steal the money or did the money ever, did it belong to you? If it didn't belong to you, some people would say you stole it. So should you give it back, or did you steal it, or is that considered stealing? We've got to do the right things, folks. We got to do the right thing. $40,000 is a lot of money. Somebody's missing their money. We got to do the right thing.
Okay, hold on now. This got too emotional. We getting out of the fact. He done bought that couch. Okay, Jay says, where was the money found, Bob? I'll answer it for you. His couch.
His couch. Whose couch? Who is his?
The man that bought it.
The man that bought it. Oh, gosh. Okay. All right.
The Lord gave him that couch. No.
Don't go. Oh, Lord. Don't go down.
You know how folks do. The Lord placed that in my
hand. Yeah, right. You go to the store and your favorite, one of your favorite foods is Vienna sausages. You go and first thing you walk in the store, there's a shelf right in your face and they're stocked with Vienna sausages. And you've been having a taste for them all day and thinking about them, and then your favorite food. They'll go, oh, Lord, the Lord bless me with these Vienna. So you're going to wreck them all in your purse? Because that's the first thing you saw when you walked in the store. The Lord bless the women, because I've been thinking about them all day.
The Lord said, don't miss your blessing. Get it while you got it. No.
You better put out some money for them. Vienna sausages. I mean, anyway, this is a good topic.
I said, where we going?
I mean, but what I'm saying is, back in the day, that's what people used to eat. Oh, my goodness. Vienna sausages and crackers? Or, my God. Or, you know, little bread and some Vienna sausages and a knee-high grape or a knee-high peach or something?
Man, you can't find that stuff.
Oh, you can't find that stuff anymore.
You know, that used to be in the store. I don't even see that no more. I see Orange Crush. I see, you know, RC.
Yeah.
I see Tahitian Treat, if you know.
You don't see knee-high anymore?
I used to.
Knee-high peach, orange, and grape and... Oh, Fanta Orange.
It's like they stopped the last few months.
There was a Fanta Orange. There was a knee-high orange. There was another orange out there.
There's a lot of Fanta.
Orange Crush.
That's what I just
meant. Oh, gosh. Those orange drinks back in the day, it really tasted orange. I mean, you could taste the orange in them, and it was very, very good.
Orange Crush is everywhere.
Yeah. It doesn't taste orange like it used to be, though.
I like it. It's smooth.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, Frankie.
It's mysterious way.
The Lord works in mysterious ways.
And his wonders to amaze.
That's true. Now, that's scripture.
Yeah.
That's right. You right, Frankie. I can't throw stones at you on that one, man. But you remember back in the days, folks, where they had Vienna sausages? You pop the can open, and then you get your Vienna sausages out or your crackers, and then you eat them. Do people still eat that stuff like that today? I mean, you know, some of it is, you know, a little high in sodium. And then, oh, don't get beside yourself. Folks, some people would eat the Vienna sausages, or some people, before they eat the Vienna sausage, they peel the top off the can. Some people would drink the juice in the Vienna sausages. Yes, drink the juice down. They say it was good. And then they would eat the sausages out. So, did you drink the juice from the Vienna sausages? And you know
how much sodium's in that thing?
I know.
What in the world?
I know, but, you know, some people love the juice. They would drink the juice from the Vienna sausages. You know, and
can't do it.
Back in the day, you know, those jugglers was so rough, you know, sodium would run from them. They drink it. Sodium would run. You know, they drink that stuff, man, and keep on walking. But that old stuff, what called Vienna sausages, potted meat. I don't know about that. Potted meat, you know, and things like that. That was
what is potted meat? Like, what is it?
It's just a little small can.
I've seen those, but
yeah, it's I don't know. Don't tell me. I don't know what's in there, but but you know, they spread it out over some bread, make good sandwiches. Or, you know, make toast bread and spread it over, make a good sandwich or something. And some people used to eat that stuff back in the day. Potted meat, Vienna sausage. I'm not going to lie. I did. Yes, I did. You know, hey. Hey,
Jason, man, I got a cabinet full of Vienna sausages right now. Real talk.
Real talk.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, gee. Hey.
Kelly says, most definitely, Mr. Bob, every day. I got a coworker that does that every day. Every day, my God. And he drinks the juice like water.
I do it. I do that with people. I saw people do it. So, Kelly, is he an older guy, though? He has to be an older guy.
Oil sausage. Yeah. Oil. That's basically what it is, yeah.
Oh, is that what they call it? Oil, yeah. Sausage? Yeah. But anyway, Vienna sausages were the thing back then, man, and they are today. They're not bad at all. But I don't know, what can they do to get the sodium level down? I think that sodium stuff is in there just to help preserve it, you know, stuff like that.
Well, look.
Find a better way.
What you got to do is sacrifice and pour that stuff out once you open it.
Yeah.
You can't drink it. You got to pour it out, put some water in
there. I don't know. Some people like that juice from the Vienna sausages.
Frankie says, I've never eaten Vienna sausage, but I have eaten potted meat and sardines.
Potted meat and sardines. Yes, sardines. They would take sardines from the can and, you know, squeeze them. Or some people would take the sardines, the fish like sardines,
yeah,
and they would eat them whole. Just eat them just like they are.
Look, and I hear that you can do that, but look,
yeah,
I see sardines in the store all the time, and I've wanted to try, because I've heard crazy things about it, but
it smells now.
Yeah, that's what I've heard.
Yeah,
it's, you know, don't, like, if you have to go out socially and talk to people, you know, wait till after you're through with
it. It's not only talking, because once you open it up and get exposed to it, it's going to be all over you.
Oh, Lord.
Your smell is going to be all over you.
Good grief.
And, you know, people.
Strong.
Yes. And what? People think you. But anyway. Yeah. but, you know, it's Vienna sausages. Oh, it's, I mean, sardines is not that bad.
Yeah, they got all sorts. They got some that sit in hot sauce.
Yeah. And,
some in oil and water.
Yes. You know. And Frankie, you know, I don't know why you eat potted meat and not buy any sausages. I mean, I don't understand that. Maybe, okay, Frankie, today go get you a can of iron sausages and taste them.
And throw down.
And drink the juice.
You need crackers, though, don't you?
Crackers.
Yeah.
Or you can eat the light bread. And you know what I mean. Loaf bread. Regular bread.
Okay.
Jason. And roll it around the Vienna sausages and eat it that way.
Yeah.
Or, yeah.
Jay says, I'm not a juice drinker, though. And sardine salad and crackers is the bomb.
I've heard that, Jay.
Forget about it.
I have heard that.
Sardine salad?
Sardine salad. I've heard some people say that. I've never had it, though.
Never in my life.
I've never had the sardine salad. I'm not a juice drinker, though.
Yeah, that's what I'm
saying. Okay, but, I mean, try the juice, GKP, and then let me know what you think. Just drink one time. Just drink the juice off of the Vienna sausages. You got
a whole cabinet.
He got a whole cabinet full, but don't drink all of the juice. Just one can.
We want you to be around.
Yeah. Oh, my God. But, yeah, just drink some people back in the day.
Yeah.
You know, back out in the fields when they worked in the...
Oh, my bad.
When they worked in the cotton fields
mm-hmm.
and things of that nature, or in the... You know, when you went to haul hay or, you know, back on the farm, you know the things you do. When you go out for the day, you have your lunchbox or you go to work on a regular job at your desk. You would have your lunchbox back, you know, when they used to work.
Mm-hmm.
And
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And they would have, you know, a couple cans of Vienna sausage, you know, a half a sleeve of crackers or something, and a can of drink or something in there, or, you know, and, you know, things like that, or, you know, and then they would eat that during lunch. You know, they would drink the juice off of the Vienna sausages, and, you know, and then that way, Sharon Fraser. Thanks for watching. Now, let me ask you, we're talking about some things. I don't know if you heard about the old-fashioned food, the Vienna sausages, the knee-high peach and orange and all of that good stuff. Have you had Vienna sausages? Do you like Vienna sausages? Do you drink the juice off of the sausages? Or potted meat or sardines?
You came into quite the conversation, yeah, but it's old school stuff.
It's old school stuff.
So we wanted some people have what, it.
I mean, not saying that you're old, but I'm saying, are you?
I ain't old.
are you familiar with that? People had that back in the day for lunch, that type of thing.
Okay, Shane said, I don't think you're supposed to drink the juice. The juice was there to keep it.
I agree.
You're supposed to wash the juice off the Vienna sausage, but I could be wrong.
But I could be wrong. Well, yeah, some people drink the juice. We've had some people on here say they drink
say
the juice.
They do.
And others back in the day, I've seen them drink the juice off of it, the flavor of it, you know, and I drank, you know, the juice a couple of times.
You took a sip. Oh,
no. I just, you know, just saw what everybody else was doing.
A youngin'. Yeah,
as a youngin'.
Jets.
Frankie
said, my dad used to love the sardines and the red pepper and potted meat.
Oh.
So I ate it with him when I was a child, but never drank the juice. The folks stayed away from that. Jet says, drink Vienna sausage juice just one time is all it will take. Next thing, you're waking up dead.
How do you wake up dead? How do you wake up dead? I don't understand that, Jet.
Jay says, I'm with Sharon. Oh, Lord.
Oh, boy, I tell you. But, no. Yeah, I mean, you know, just one time. And now, some of you people that have problems, you probably don't want to deal with the juice.
Don't do it.
You know, of the Vienna sausages and things of that nature.
Do not.
But I know back in the day, you know, when they, you know, the old stuff we're talking about. They had Vienna sausages, and then they had potted meat. They had sardines. Do you think some young people eat that stuff today? Do you think people that smoke marijuana eat sardines.
That smoke marijuana. Good grief.
I mean, they might eat anything after smoking marijuana. Some people say, man, marijuana makes you hungry. Does anybody know? Let me know. Does it make you hungry?
Jay.
I'm just saying. I'm not saying. See, some people try to say, oh, he's trying to see if I smoke marijuana. But no. Don't answer that question. But Jay says,
Let's see. Jay says, I'm with Sharon.
Okay.
And yeah, I actually read him. Okay.
Yeah. Jay said, you wake up. No, you're waking up dead. Well, I mean, there is an afterlife after this life. I mean, you know, you keep living, but, you know, yeah, your body might not be.
Depends on where you wake up. You
yeah,
know,
your body might not be too responsive after drinking that juice. JP said, what did he say?
Stop it, Bob.
Yeah, okay. I'm just saying, Jet, you know, GKP, you know what time it is. Really, you know what time it is. I mean, name some other old-fashioned foods. Sardines, potted meat, Vienna sausages.
Charlie Harper in the building.
Charlie Harper, welcome to the show. Charlie Harper, have you ever heard of or have you eaten Vienna sausages, potted meat, sardines, and have you ever drank the juice from the Vienna sausages? I mean, yeah, okay. And Sharon says what?
First of all, we all grew up with processed meat. You realize that is processed meat, which is no way good for us, but we've had that in our environment.
Mm-hmm.
Now, regarding sardines, H no. Once again, they are in juice, and you're 100% right, it stinks.
Mm.
I'm sorry, there's just certain food I'm not going to eat, especially something that stinks. Can't something that's been processed in juice. I think there's better things to eat.
Yeah.
It is.
Okay, let's say, what are better things to eat without juice? Bologna.
You going to all
bologna don't have juice. It's still processed, though. Man. I mean, everything's processed. You have to bless it and receive it with thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and everything give thanks.
But now, and I don't think, like, you know, you don't want to just go.
You don't want to, you don't want to just go around.
Consume.
Hey, Lord, I'm gonna eat this and bless it because you said bless it. I'm gonna eat the wrong thing. I'm gonna eat everything. You know, I'm gonna eat hog maw and hog jaws and. And everything else, and knowing that it's not good for me, but I'm going to eat it anyway, but I'm going to bless it.
Yeah, that ain't going to work.
GKP says.
Yeah, I know, Bob. LOL. High times. Oh, man.
Charlie Harper?
He says, good morning. Sardines are good for you.
Yo! Yes. That's what some people say. They say sardines are good for you, but what about the juice, Charlie? Does sardines have juice? It's been a long time.
I guess
it does. I don't know. But what about Vienna sausages, Charlie Harper? Are you telling me that you've never had Vienna sausages? Or padded meat? I mean, potted meat?
Hey, look, she says, H&O bologna is even processed unless it's 100% beef.
Beef. Oh, you like beef bologna. Bologna.
Well, I'm assuming.
Or is it bologna?
Hey, bologna.
Bologna. Okay.
I know we're talking about.
Bologna. Just say bologna.
Yeah.
Okay. And so if it's beef bologna, is it okay? Is that what you're saying? I don't know. I mean, you don't find much beef bologna in the stores when you go. I mean, it's a lot of processed, what do you call it, mixed, all meat bologna, that's what they call it.
Yeah, all meat.
Mm-hmm. All meat, yeah, bologna, and the rag bologna, but I am concerned this morning, and we're about out of time,
mm-hmm.
Vienna sausages, it's good, it is, but be careful, folks, and if you have to drink the juice, just one time. And So don't hurt yourself. Potted meat? I don't know about potted meat. It's not any juice, I don't think, in potted meat, is there?
I'm sure there is.
I don't know.
I'm sure there is. I've never had it, but I'm sure there is.
Charlie Harper said,
yes, I've eaten Vienna sausages, but only small portions.
Small portions.
Vienna is a pork product.
Oh, no kidding. But okay, Charlie, he says, but only a small portion. But only small portions. So Charlie is one of those that popped a little can of Vienna sausages, eat two of them out of it, and set the other ones back on the shelf for later day, later in the day. I mean.
You can't even do that?
No, you can't.
I didn't think so.
So Charlie's going to open a can of Vienna sausages, only get one or two out, and then leave to throw the rest of them away? Or are you going to save them for another day or another time? But how do you save them? You can't. Some folks say you can't leave it in the can. Yeah, I don't know. Sharon says what?
She says, yes, you're right. Unless it's beef, it has all types of animal parts. And yes, it's harder to find beef nowadays because it's cheaper to with all the animal parts.
Yeah.
And I will not do that.
Right. Gotcha. Okay. All right. And whoa, what a day we've had today. It is now 9:58, 58 minutes past the hour, 9 o'clock and Central Time. Yes.
We've done everything from Harry and Meghan, who's no longer wanted to be called that, trying out of the royal family. And then we talked about the man that found $40,000 plus in the seat cushions of the couch bought at a thrift store.
Yeah.
Should he or shouldn't he have given the money back? I'm going to ask Sharon this real quick. Charlie Harper, too. Whoever else is there real quick.
Yeah.
If you didn't hear. If you found $40,000 in the seat cushions of a couch that you bought from a thrift store, would you return the money and try to find out who it belonged to? Or would you say this is a blessing from the Lord and keep that money? What's right? What's wrong? Is there a right or wrong?
Is there a right or wrong
in this
here?
Situation?
Should you return the money? Now, you don't know who it belonged to. You went to a thrift store and you bought the couch and it had $40,000 in it.
Mm-hmm.
Charlie says what?
LOL, he'll eat the whole can. He said, but not every week. Maybe once every 2 months.
Once a year.
Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe he's buying his sausages only once a year.
Well, he said once every 2 months.
Once every two months. But no, I was B. King saying that. So yeah. What is it? Christmas time?
Christmas comes.
Once the year.
Year.
Yeah. That's where we got that from. He said, let's eat the whole can. Okay. All right. But I think Charlie don't drink the juice.
Don't do it.
I don't know if he drinks the juice or not.
Don't do it.
Yeah, so. What do you eat it with, Charlie? Do you eat it with bread or do you eat it with crackers? Or are there certain crackers? Or do you eat it with regular saltine crackers or with the no salt crackers? I don't know why I said that. But anyway, do you eat it with, what's that other crackers you have? I'm not talking about white folks. Listen, it's time for me to go. Do you eat it with the Ritz cracker? That's what I'm saying. The Ritz crackers.
Hold up. Okay, she says, as a Christian person, an honest person, yes, you're supposed to give the money back. But as a black person, age no. What?
Wait a minute.
I didn't know there was a difference.
Wait a minute. No, she said, but as a black person, he'll know.
I think it meant the other way. Because other words, that wouldn't make sense.
Yeah. Charlie says he eat it with the saltine crackers.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. Well, yeah, that's the way they used to eat it, Charlie, with the saltine crackers. And do any of you, and you too, Charlie, do you eat the Vienna sausages and the saltine crackers or the Ritz crackers or the bread? Do you eat it with knee-high peach, knee-high orange, or knee-high grape?
Hey, y'all know this, these details. Uh-huh.
What do you, I mean, have you ever heard of the knee-high peach? And the knee-high orange and knee-high grape.
We could probably continue this conversation.
Or the red pop. How many of you do remember the soda called the red pop?
Red pop is not good to me.
Back in the day, I think it was good. Today, yeah. I don't know what they
well, like, it's.
I hadn't even tasted a red pop in years.
But like, I had it once, and it's weird. Maybe it's just because it's weird. Like, I've never had a flavor like that, a red. It's just weird. I don't know how to describe it. Mm. But I do like Tahitian Treat.
Tahitian?
Treat.
What's that?
It's a fruit punch. Y'all know what that is.
Oh, yeah, yes, yes. I got you now.
Yeah.
Okay, I thought
you... It's because you're reading the comments.
Yeah, yeah. No, no, no. Yeah.
No,
no, no, no, no, no, no.
Yeah.
I thought you were talking about some type of meat. What is that? No. What is that meat they got in the... I can't stand it. No, not treat. It's close to it, though. I don't like treat either, but it's called... What is that? Is it a square can?
Oh, spam.
Spam. Yes. Oh, my goodness. How could you? Oh, my goodness. It's time to go now.
Oh, Kelly says, and if you really want to get fancy, Mr. Bob, you can eat with club crackers.
Club crackers. Yes.
Now, that's the expensive
now, thing. That's where you're going right there.
I love club crackers. Are the
oh, yes. That'll even change the taste of hyena sausages.
Of anything.
But not spam.
No.
Oh, probably God, not. No. Spam? I can't. Some people say they love spam.
Yeah.
I've heard several people talk about how much they love spam. I cannot see it, folks.
Spam and eggs, that's right here.
I can't see
like
it.
They scramble it in there.
I can't see it. I just can't. Spam is not a good meat.
A spam sandwich?
A spam sandwich?
I don't understand that either.
God. Cannot eat spam.
Shane said, for real, as a black person, if I found some money, no, I don't give it back, just being real.
No.
No, I hear you, though.
You would not give it back, buddy. Hey. But that's a Christian. Okay, so that means you can't be a black Christian.
Black and a Christian. Like, agree.
So, you know, so you're black. You give it away first as a black person. Keep it as a black person first and then pray over it later as a Christian.
See, that's where people go wrong. People think as Christians are stupid. That you look, see, and I think that's like with that story. With the guy, you know, saying, oh, I did the... Look, and I'm not calling him stupid. If he wants to do that, that's cool.
Yeah, that's true.
But I'm just saying, don't think that in a situation like that, that you have to. People feel like you're obligated. You're
and
going,
what story that is that?
With the money, the couch.
Oh, okay.
That
yeah.
you're going to hell if you don't give that money.
Yeah.
Try to find out whose money that is. That's not true.
Yeah.
At all.
Well, Charlie says what?
I eat it with water. Because he said, which is the best thing for the body?
Eat what with water?
Maybe spam. I'm not sure.
No.
About the finding the money in the couch. No, I will not return the money because after I purchased the couch legally, it is my possession. Even the spots or duns in the couch.
Oh well, they belong to you, all right. But not that $40,000 though, Charlie. No, I'm kidding. That's what I was thinking. Okay. Everything else, the dirt and everything else in the couch belongs to you. They'll let you keep that, but yet the $40,000 don't belong to you. How is that?
Sharon says she loves spam.
Okay. Sharon, bless your heart. I'm going to pray for you today.
I'm surprised you like spam, but not the bologna. Well, here we go.
How can you not like, how can you like spam and then like bologna or
Vianus.
I don't understand that.
See, spam is the higher class.
No, it's not.
That's what they try.
No, it's not. That's what they try to portray. I don't see how people can say that. How can you say that? Spam is not.
Look at that can.
No, it's not.
The little pop top. You know?
Yeah, it's got that little key on. Think of the key.
Yeah.
Do they still have the key on top of it?
I think so.
Okay.
But I never heard of a can with a key. That's
but crazy. What is the key for?
Unlock the spam.
It rolls the can around, I guess. It still does it the old way.
I have no clue.
Oh, my goodness.
Frankie says, I'm black and I'm Christian and I'm keeping the money and I'm still saying hallelujah.
Oh, my goodness. I love these assholes. Frankie, you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Jet says, speaking of crackers and Vienna sausage, what's going on with Donald Trump and Keith?
Oh, come on.
Come on, man. How you going to put them two together? Good grief. Okay. That's quite a pair. Good grief.
Yeah, who's that other person there?
Marvin King.
Marvin King, thanks for being in with us today.
He says, spam comes from a spig.
Spig, not a pig.
Yeah. Like ham comes from a pig, right?
Ham, yeah. I understand that, Marvin. But spam? What is spam?
Comes from a spig.
It's a spam is a ham. It comes from a spig and not a pig. That's good. I like that, Marvin. I like that. That is a good one. Well, folks, that's going to do it for us today. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Thank you. We've had fun. That's what it's all about, having fun. Sharon has a big comment there, Josh. I am afraid. Go ahead on.
I know spam is not good, but yes, it is processed. But me, I do like my spam, and that's probably only in me. I would buy even if I know it's not good for me. Well, a lot of people have those things.
Yeah, but I mean, come on now. If you're going to buy something worth eating and you know it's not good for you, not spam. You know what? Josh, I need to revisit it.
You think so?
It's been years.
I'm trying to think if I ever had it.
Since I've had some spam.
I think I have once.
I've got to go back and revisit it and see what they... Maybe I'm missing something, folks. I don't know. But I despised spam. I just didn't like it. What is in it?
Charlotte Harper says, if I actually found... in the couch, I wouldn't tell nobody.
Okay, Charlie's smart.
Yeah, that's actually smart.
Just don't say nothing about it.
Look, you imagine running outside.
But Charlie, you don't have to tell everybody. God knows.
The Lord is watching.
The Lord is watching you. But see, there you go. Somebody's trying to convict somebody with the Lord on it now. I'm not trying to do that to you, Charlie. Just don't tell anybody. Sharon says, oh God, they're not going to let us leave. Josh, I'm dying. Sharon says what?
And since you're talking about food that's not good for you, I want to encourage people to stop buying Top Ramen. Ramen noodles, I guess.
Ramen noodles,
especially our people. It's going to kill you. That's why we have, we put it in communities that are low income. That's why you have 9 feet. And you have every flavor. I think you probably missed every flavor, but when you go to a white store, they have 3 feet because they ain't going to buy it like we do. Just being real. Stop buying Top Ramen and Energy 5 or 5.
So it's in the black community, they put most of that stuff like that.
That's true.
Okay, and that's what I said about chicken places. Church's Chicken, KFC Chicken. KFC, they'll put it in the white community.
Yeah, they'll take that.
Church's Chicken, you don't see no Church's Chicken in the white community.
No.
Yeah, you don't. You might see a Popeye's almost there.
Popeye's is getting close.
Getting close.
To joining.
And the other chicken is what? Jack Purtle.
Jack Purtle,
now they white folk that own it.
Yeah.
But they throw them all in the hood.
Well, they know, look, and to be real, they know where they're going to get their money.
I mean,
there are some white folks that'll come and find a Jack Purtle.
But why don't they put them chicken houses in the white community?
I think there's one.
Yeah.
They gave them one.
We're trying to get out of here. Who is this?
Mr. Keith Williams.
No. Let me.
To accept.
Oh, Keith. Keith.
Keith hung up.
He hung up.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, Kelly says gas station chicken.
Gas station chicken.
You know what? Memphis, what that Memphis is good for? Depends on the gas station.
It all depends.
They got some good, some gas station around here got some good food.
Yeah, that's right. They do.
That's something that got a real spread at some of these places around here. So shout out to Memphis for that. Charlie says,
Charlie, you're wrong.
Chicken died that we may live.
We may live. Frankie, we've got to go now.
Yeah. Josh, she never had ramen noodles either.
Read her comment.
She said, I've never had ramen noodles, vienna sausage, or Spam.
Ah.
Wow. Well, one of those is good, you know.
You never had ramen noodles, vienna sausage, or Spam. Well, it's been a long time for Spam for me. Ramen noodles, it's been a long time with that, too. Vienna sausage, well, all those has really been a long time for me. Anyway. Sharon, thank you. Good show. And thanks for joining, and thanks to all of you joining us. Mm-hmm. And that's going to do it for us today. And it's on my Keith.
Come on.
Keith called us. But anyway, I'm not going to get on that. No, I'm not going there. But anyway, y'all have a blessed day today. Have a wonderful day. And thank you for checking in with us. And we'll... How long has the gas station had chicken?
Oh.
They do that all the time. That's an old thing. That's an old thing.
All over Memphis.
You
can get, like, full meals.
Yeah.
You can get a whole dinner for some of these. In Memphis, I know Shane, I don't think she's from Memphis, but.
No.
In Memphis, you can get
Oregon
a full.
Oregon or Washington, I think.
A full dinner.
Yeah.
At a gas station in Memphis.
Oh, yeah.
They got all sorts of stuff
all
later.
All kinds of stuff there. And,
you go to the right one, you can get some good food.
And, you know, and. It's been a long time, but some of the chicken at some of these gas stations are better than from Texas or, you know, KFC. Some of these chickens, some of that stuff is pretty good.
We will not support that. So do know that we are not over here just twiddling our thumbs. We are fighting for the rights of teachers in this county.
Look, man, you messing up my show about Vienna sausages and Spam. What did I call? Okay, I'm sorry. Please, do not interrupt anymore.
Jed says, I'm embarrassed to say, but man, gas station cuisine is the best.
Yeah, that is. That's good stuff there. Yeah, Sharon, she's from Washington, she said.
Okay.
And Jay, GKP.
Hey, Bob, I ain't giving no money back. Y'all already know who it is.
Okay, hey, y'all have a wonderful day.
Yeah.
And thanks for joining us. We'll talk to you next time.
Listening to Talk Back Live with Bob and Josh, talking about current events and topics that matter.
This is Sergeant Chris Richardson with the Tennessee Highway Patrol. Pedestrian safety is a two-way street. Both drivers and walkers need to do their part to keep roads safe. When you're walking, remember, the drivers may not always see you, so remember to use these tips to continue to walk safely. Wear black clothes, always use crosswalks, and obey signs. Lights and reflectors should be used. And finally, keep alert and do not walk distracted. This message brought to you by the Tennessee Highway Patrol.
CJ Used Appliances, located at 3530 Jackson Avenue here in Memphis, Tennessee. Call them at 901-487-7882. CJ Used Appliances have the best prices in town, sales and service, heating and air. Also, the best appliances you'll find anywhere in the Mid-South. Refrigerators, microwave stoves, washers and dryers, deep freezers, dishwashers, whatever you need in used appliances. And folks, I'm telling you, they're the best used appliances anywhere you'll find. That's CJ Used Appliances, 3530 Jackson Avenue. All appliances come with warranty. You can call them at 901-487-7882. Again, 901-487-7882, CJ Used Appliances.
T-Graphic Printing, located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis, a complete print shop for all your printing needs. They do it all. Telecopy, resumes, funeral programs, rubber stamps, full-color business cards, wedding and graduation invitations, and more. 30-plus years of quality work and service. They're open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis, Tennessee, 901-345-9294. T-Graphic Printing.
Max Back Taxes, 4422 Yale Road here in Memphis, Tennessee, 901-382-1414. Get the maximum back on your taxes. It is now tax season. 15 years in business. Precise, professional, and honest. Hey, you need to go by Max Back Taxes. 4422 Yale Road. Call 901-382-1414 and talk to Tamara. Get the maximum back on your taxes with Max Back Taxes.